Hi, I am Murat Kendir, a geometric engineer and also a JS developer. I want to introduce to you a new QGIS plugin, which I developed in Python language. Call it CZML Billboard Maker. It can be useful for create CZML, including billboards or labels or both of them. You can install it using QGIS plugin manager. But remember that you should also check the show also experimental plugins here in plugin manager settings. Then you can search for CZML in plugin manager. This is our QGIS plugin. There are two ways to access to this plugin. Here in user interface, it's a icon. It's just like a billboard, or navigate to the web menu, CZML Billboard Maker, and point to the CZML billboards. So what is CZML? CZML is Cesium language file. It's JSON-based, also time dynamic file. It can be useful to represent labels, images as billboards, and 3D geometries, and also 3D models in Cesium platform, Cesium environment. If you wanna learn more about the CZML formats, you can search for CZML guides and visit the GitHub page. Official GitHub page. Also, you can search for other geometries and features and other things. We used only billboard and label objects in our plugin. Let's get started with look over our JS data. First thing first, it should be in VGS 84 coordinate system, as you can see here. It's commonly known as EPSG4326. It should be a vector layer, and its geometry should be a point geometry. And here are the fields. If you want to use the time sequences, you should give two datetime fields. Its field type should be date time. One of them is starting time, and the other one is the end time. Let's look over for data. Here are our data. One important thing here is image URL. You can use relative path with folder name, which consists in your images. If you don't use any folder for images, just give the image names as image URL. And our beginning time and end time are here at lowest temperature and highest temperature. Feel free to create new fields, new label fields. You don't need to use always the name as labels in your CZML file. And let's get started with creating our first CZML file. Okay, we are starting with creating our first CZML file. And we should firstly select the proper layer to create a CZML file. This layer selection tool only filters point geometries. You cannot see your raster data and also the polygon or line string layers. Select proper layer, and after that click populate attributes. You see it's same attributes as our layer have. And select firstly the ID column, ID attribute, and then give the name field. After that, select which attribute should be seen as labels in the CZML file. We have here concatenate label field, and then select the image field, which contains relative paths of the image. Description and height are optional parameters. You can select, but it's not essential. Okay. And we should select a file name. Give a simple name for it. And save. Click OK. Let's navigate to the folder which we have saved our first CZML file. Here is our first CZML file, and here is the image folder. Please consider that CZML image folder should be in same path with the CZML file if you have given a relative path. And if you want to use this CZML file in Cesium Ion account, in your Cesium Ion account, you can select them together and compress and make a zip file, and basically upload this zip file to the Cesium Ion account. You can open CZML file with any of Notepad or similar software. Here is our document. A brief description and positions and labels, also billboard and parameters, our ID, name, and description fields. If you're running a local web server or in any other base running Cesium platform, you should basically upload your CZML file and image folder to your server. I have a sample server here and upload. If needed, you can overwrite. And let's test it. You can see labels have come, and also images are here. The label name are here. If you select any object in CZML file, you can see name and description together. Now we will try give a time sequence to our features. It's an optional feature in CZML Billboard Maker plugin. You can select this option to activate it, and you should select the beginning time and time. And also you can use time zone. You can select the time zone here. We are in +3 time zone in here, Turkey. And but the first I should show you, I filtered this data for you to show the first example, and I have a delete filter, checking data here. As you can see, here are five different time sequences for same place with different temperatures. And let's export this file again. You should remember that the fields in datetime beginning and datetime end should be datetime format, and you can select also UTS time zone here. Let's upload the CZML file again and refresh our server. You may see your features, your labels not here because of date. Cesium in default uses today as current date. As you see, I changed the time to back. And yeah, you have seen different features with different time sequences. Another important feature is in our plugin is the configuring clock. Most commonly, the Cesium clock is configured directly inside the Cesium JavaScript code blocks, but you can also configure this clock, the time of the time behavior of the Cesium inside the CZML file. You should select the current date, which will begin with this date. I mean, the animation of the Cesium will begin with this date, and you should give a beginning time. And ending time. You can specify your multiplier. And export this file again. Overwrite your less CZML file in server and refresh the Cesium test page. As you can see, the Cesium clock is configured with our configuration. Our multiplier is shown here and starts with 15 January and ends with 19 January. And also labels and images are changed with given features. I want to show you an additional trick about CZML labels. I start the field calculator here and create a new field. And show you, it should be string. You can concatenate any of the fields which you have in your data file, for example, the description or any other thing. If you want a new line in your labels, you should use the new line character, but with one more additional backslash. And at lowest temperature, highest temperature, and a slash here. Okay, you should see this string. The backslash is skipping the new line character for the QGIS. Also, this new line character should be directly go to the CZML file as this string. One more additional trick, if you want to check your time sequence of your data, you can use Time Manager in QGIS plugin. If you don't have, please install it using Plugin Manager, and you can give let's start from the beginning. You should add your layer, which you use in a CZML file. Also, the same logic is here. It is give the start time, give the end time. Click OK. You can check the looping animation button. Press OK. Press power on. 8 hours is good for our animation, and click play. that's it. I can check my time sequences with Time Manager directly inside the QGIS without exporting data to the CZML. One more additional trick about datetime attributes. If you downloaded any GeoJSON file from any sources, you may notice that your data has not actually a datetime field which shown as commonly used formats, but these are also another standard called time epoch. Each integer represents the milliseconds in a specific time. You should convert them to a datetime field, datetime attribute. You can use field calculator, give the datetime type, and let's write the attribute name. In QGIS, there is a function called datetime from epoch. Use this, give the attribute number which consists the epoch of the time. You can see here our epoch data converted directly to the datetime field, which we can use in CCML file. And here is our new datetime field. Okay, see you later. Thank you.